Hey, is that folk music that you play there? What is that? How do you call that folk music?
I think it was Studs Terkel who asked Big Bill Brunze, did he consider his blues music to be folk music? And Big Bill says, well, never heard no horse.
Just before lightning, but not before thunder. Like just before Jesus walked on the water. I am so close, baby, I can taste it on my tongue. Like spice and fire, like cinnamon. Even though I am bound here by my bones, flesh and blood will fail someday. I can only kneel and pray. Ah, these are hot summer nights. I stay up with the moon and the sun come up too soon, finds me dreaming of you. I'm going in the extra innings, extra frames, bowling $4 at the Bowl Marley. Even though I am bound here by my bones, flesh and blood will fail someday, and I can only kneel and pray. I don't have to be next big thing, you can be just who you are. Everything is everything, and everybody is a star. Just before lightning, not before thunder. Even though I am down here, bound here by my bones, don't have to be the next big thing. You can be just who you are. Everything is everything, and everybody is a star. And everybody is a star.
Yeah. The show is Horses Sing None of It. My name is Ralph Litwin. Our guest today is a fine songwriter and a personable young gentleman named Andy Scott. Thank New you, York City.
Thank you very much for having me.
Also known as, or formerly known as, the artist Goat.
The artist formerly known as Goat. Yeah, that's me.
How you doing, Andy?
I'm doing fine, thank you.
That's a great song. What was the name of that?
Everybody is a Star.
It's cool. Nice sentiment.
Well, I live in this little apartment in Manhattan, and looking out the window, I've got a beautiful church, St. Anthony's Church. And over the holidays, they have a beautiful nativity scene. And I wrote that song, one of those points where I wasn't sure where my next breath was coming from. And I looked out the window on that cold Christmas day, and it just kind of hit me. I don't have much to worry about. Everything's going to be fine.
Good for you.
Mm-mm. Nothing like a little pain and misery to make you say something nice.
What else would you like to sing for us?
Well, geez, you know, that would be a goat song that I just played there. That's from a record called All of My Friends. And now that we're doing this Andy Scott thing, music's changed a little bit. I don't want to say just because I got a little older, but I think that had something to do with it. Now, this is a song called Who Doesn't Caw, and I got a little animated video of it that wound up on YouTube and got all kinds of hits and downloads.
Oh, great.
I'd love to play that for you.
Great. I love that song.
Mm-hmm. Are you going to play with me?
Sure.
All right. Get the phone. Who lets it ring until they know that I'm not there to say hello? Who would speak and not be known? Just a voice from the unknown, desires to be left alone. Who doesn't call when I'm not home? Someone's trying to reach me. Who it is, I do not know. Maybe a friend or long-lost lover, just out of reach, but not of hope. Talk a while, even if you've misdialed. Tell me your story, I'll tell you mine. Heaven knows I got the time. Who doesn't call when I'm not home? When I'm not there to say hello, won't you please call again? Lover, just out of reach, but not of hope. Hello, hello, I'm almost there, a ring or two away. I'd love to talk a while, even if you misdial. Hello, hello, is somebody there? Won't you please call again?
Very nicely done.
Thank you.
That's a fine recording, too.
Yeah, that's about what we did for the recording. We just plugged in and sang and played. Got lucky on that one.
So you've been receiving some residuals, I take it, from television placements of your songs?
Residuals? Like sticky stuff? Yeah, I've...
Checks in the mail.
Well, you know, I've been failing upwards for some time now. And I've been very fortunate with some good placements in TV and movies. And I shudder to tell you what, I did have a song called Great Life, which wound up being a Kia car commercial. So that was a boon, and it enables me to go into the studio and record new records. But I'm not wearing any bling, you know. My residuals are small and residing, but it's more of a confirmation that maybe it's okay what you're doing, and television is a great way to reach a lot of people. We're such a television-oriented world these days.
Yes, we are. I'm pleased to learn that you had one placed on CSI, my favorite TV show.
Yeah, well, that was just for a trailer, for leading up to a season finale. And, that was kind of cool. It's all cool. It's all, you know, a surprise when it happens. And, I like to think of myself as a secret detective sometimes, you know. A friend of mine, you know, Law and Order Special Victims Unit?
Yeah.
You know, you watch TV, Ralph?
Yes.
Now we know. Well, you do have a TV show too, so I guess one follows the other. But a friend of mine is the lead detective on SVU, Chris, you know, the big tough guy.
Uh-huh.
And we used to do the door together at the bitter end. We were both just pups in town, and he was big and tough then too. But you know, his style of dealing with the situation was just to get that mean, scary look that he gets on his face. And I'll never forget the night we had a real problem. And it's Chris and I up at the door, and a 6'8" giant who's drunk and disgruntled. And Chris just looked at him and gave him the dirty look and walked away. And, you know, it wasn't enough to quiet this guy. And there I am sitting with this monster. And I just decided to buy him a drink and let it go from there. But that's my Chris Maloney story. A lot of cats came through those doors down on Bleecker Street.
We should let folks know how they can find out about your new recording. They can go to andyjazz.com.
Yeah, www.andyjazz.com. And it's that record right there, Don't Tempt Fate. And it's available at iTunes and a bunch of other places.
And they can find out, at your website, they can find out about your schedule for upcoming performances.
Yes, they can. Yes, they can.
Why don't you give us another tune?
What would you like to hear? I know it.
I have to refer to the album.
No, that's all right. That's all right.
Okay, you know what I want to hear.
Well, you know, this is a song off this new record called Learning to Fly. Thank you. flying or falling. Won't know till she hits the ground. No one watching, nobody else around. Learning to fly, learning to fall, willing to try, and through it all, keep smiling. Like a tsunami wave come crashing through my door. Origami hands, folding paper worlds. Who are these ghosts? She would like to know. Following everywhere she goes, everywhere. Learning to fly, learning to fall, willing to try, and through it all, keep smiling. After all, you're beautiful. Today, what information came your way? Did it amuse you? Assimilate and use it. True to yourself, true to your dreams. Made strong by gravity, no strings, no strings. Learning to fly. Learning to fall, willing to try, and through it all, keep smiling. After all, you're beautiful. Learning to fly, beautiful. Learning to fly.
You did know exactly what I wanted to hear.
Yeah.
I love that line where you rhyme tsunami and origami.
Yeah. Yeah, that was before that big tidal wave came. I thought about singing it, you know, after the big horrible tidal wave came and killed so many people, and I had written this song with tsunami wave in it, and it gave me pause. I wasn't trying to predict the future or anything, but the words certainly had more widespread meaning
after
that
event.
Kind of thing happens. Yeah. It's funny how songs will do that sometimes. You know, you'll write a song, or I'll write a song, and boy, I write a lot of bad songs, Ralph, but every now and then I get a good one, and I don't always know what it means when I'm writing it, but somehow I know when it's done. And then sometimes, you know, years later, the song will catch up to you. And you go, that's what was going on. Yeah. I'm telling you, songs, I've written some of my best songs in my darkest moments, like that song, Great Life, you know, that I told you about. Start having a great life. Well, everything had come to a screeching halt at that moment. And a fellow I was working with said, it looks like this could be the last time you set foot in the studio and record, so what would you like to say? Make it good. Came up with Start Having a Great Life, Start Living with Inspiration. So, I won't play that song for you, though.
Well, tell us about what song you are going to play for us.
Well, I'd like to play a song called Valium and Soda Pop. You're a parent, so you can laugh at that, huh? You know, love is a terrible thing. Crazy thing when you really love something more than the very breath you're about to take. And I'm pretty sure that's what having kids is about. Is that true, Ralph?
That's what having kids is about.
I mean, just loving something beyond anything you believed you could ever do. and watching them grow up and leave the house. And
I feel that way about my wife too.
Yeah. As we were discussing earlier, I've been married 22 years and you've been married 29 years. I'm gonna, since horses sing none of it, I guess I can switch midstream. There's a song called Calling All My Angels, and it's, I wrote this song, and just recently we had a terrible scare with a bad horse accident. My wife thought she was Roy Rogers. And she took this terrible fall, and I'm holding her, cradling her head on the floor of the woods, just really not knowing if she's ever going to open up her eyes again. And in that moment of desperation, I looked up, and I don't know who I was talking to, but I said, "Please help." And I was calling all my angels. Calling all my angels. Angels to the rescue me. Calling all my angels. Calling all my angels. No time to be strangers. I can hardly hear you crying. Hardly keep from crying. Close to me. Only for a little while. Think about you all the time. Kisses I have cried for, love that I would die for, I would do anything. Kisses I have cried for, love that I would die for, I would do anything. The clouds are falling down, floating to the ground. My dreams are falling like broken rainbows. Anything for you, anything at all. Nothing in this world too big or too small. I would move a mountain to get you when you fall. Anything for you, anything at all. I would do anything. And mirrors the sum of all my fears. I would do anything. Free falling or flying, girl won't fail for trying. Give her wings, wings on which to fly on. Never say too high on. I would do anything. Wings on which to fly on. Never say goodbye on. I would do anything. The clouds are falling down, they're floating to the ground. The dreams are falling like broken rainbows. I would do anything, anything at all. Nothing in this world too big or too small. I would move in my town to catch you when you fall. Anything for you, anything at all. I would do anything. I would move. For you.
Yeah. Would you mind talking a little bit about the kismet that brought you to the studio from New York City?
Not at all. Well, you know, I'm a big fan of your show. I've seen plenty of my friends on your show, and I was watching one show and I saw the name Five House roll on the credits. Now, how many people do you know named Five House? That's a pretty cool name. If I had a name like Five House, I never would have been Goat. And there's a studio in New York that I work at and out of called Engine Room, and there is a beautiful, beautiful woman there named Katie Five House, who's been helping me design my records and get my product together. And I called Katie. I said, Katie, you know, I'm in no way trying to be intrusive, but could that possibly be a relative of yours who run in camera for the Horses Sing None of It show? And sure enough, it's Katie's pop. And I asked her to please submit one of my records because I would really love to be on the show. And here I am. That was the kismet.
And Bob Fivehouse is behind the, sitting in the director's chair, and Gene Fivehouse is sitting here in the studio with us.
That's right. I mean, we got the good end of that deal with Gene sitting in here with us and Bob being in the other room.
Well, why don't you tag a little music on the end of the show here?
I would love to. I'll play this song, Valium and Soda Pop. Won't you play with me, please, Ralph?
Sure.
Thank you so much. Sugar melting on the table, long as I am able to go on, I will be singing the same sad song. Lover stepped out for a maybe, this time she may find her dreams. Well, I can't help thinking